Hey, crypto family. So it looks like the market's been doing better the past couple of days. We have Bitcoin up about 7.5% to $4,169. Ripple's up over 3.5% to 37.8 cents. You have Ethereum up 5.5% to $118. Bitcoin Cash up 2.5%, still underperforming, to $184. And Stellar up 4.8% to 15.6 cents. So again, good to see some of these coins in the green today. I mentioned that Bitcoin had to stay above that $4,100 level to show some bullish momentum, and it looks like we are doing that. And then looking at Bitcoin SV, that's actually up 13% to $96. So that's regained some of the losses it had yesterday. So again, you can see pretty much everything is in the green today, and a lot of coins are double digits. But looking at the trading right now on Bitcoin, so the 4-hour chart here, now I have TD sequential up, and you can see it's on a green 9 right now, which means a reversal is likely to happen to the downside. Now, how far we go, it's anyone's guess. I'm hoping we can hold this $4,100 support and then continue to the upside from there, or at least hold that $4,000 level here. So we're gonna have to see. But again, remember I drew this red line on the RSI. This was the red line that it was staying below after the drop at the $37 mark or 37 mark. And hopefully we can stay above that if we do have a drop, and then continue for some more bullish action. And then again, looking at the next resistance we have, it's going to be around this $4,500 level here, and then that $5,000 level and beyond. So again, hoping that we see a bounce in these support levels and continue on. So we'll have to see what happens in the next couple of days. But one of the first articles I want to talk about is one on CoinDesk, and it's actually about Steemit laying off over 70% of its staff because of the bear market. Now, for those who know, Steemit was one of the blog platforms that was really big in 2016. They started, and basically you can make posts, blog posts, and they can get upvoted, and you can actually earn actual currency, Steemit currency, from that, and then sell that on the market. And you know, it was a great idea, and I actually started my first blogs on that platform, and that's where I really got started with my YouTube channel and everything. And it was a great platform and really engaged a lot of people just from all around the world. But now, because of the blockchain, or because of Bitcoin and the whole market in general, and it's been going down the entire year, Steemit claims that they were expecting that the market would keep rising. And since that hasn't happened, they've been forced to lay off more than 70% of their organization and begin restructuring. So basically, they just can't pay all their employees because they don't have the revenue to do so. Because basically they were paying a lot of them, you know, with their Steemit tokens and with the fiat money made from that. But since the prices have been going down, then it's made it harder for them to do that. So unfortunately, you know, I love this company. I love what they're trying to do. But, you know, it's just a shame that during this bear market, a lot of people are having to lay off of their jobs. And, you know, in these companies, due to the coins just basically going to zero, or, you know, near zero. So hopefully Steemit can bounce back. Hopefully they get some restructuring going and can still move forward, because they're a great platform and I really hope they succeed. Now, on a more positive note, we have an article by CNBC came out today, and it talks about Amazon actually getting into the blockchain space. So Amazon has already looked into the blockchain space before. I believe they're with Quantum and a few other companies, but they're actually looking to really delve into the blockchain, you know, head on, and actually use Ethereum to do that. So it says AWS CEO Andy Jassy unveiled two new blockchain products at the Invent conference in Las Vegas on Wednesday. The company will offer Amazon Quantum Ledger Database and Amazon Managed Blockchain for developers using its cloud computing services. Amazon is introducing the services despite an almost 70% plunge this year in the price of Bitcoin. So it says, the company said on Wednesday that it's introducing two new services, including a managed blockchain offering to let Amazon Web Services customers set up, quote, a scalable blockchain network with just a few clicks. So this is great, and they're really taking the bull by the horns on this. And it says, you know, even though with the 70% drop of Bitcoin, you know, Amazon is still wanting to get into this blockchain space. Now, they also say that their new product will support two popular existing blockchain platforms, Ethereum and Hyperledger Fabric. So, you know, Ethereum hasn't really shown much reaction from this announcement, but, you know, I'm expecting that we'll see Ethereum rise a little bit more in the future because of this. But again, you know, that's good that Amazon is really taking the initiative on this and adopting blockchain because they see the advantages that it has. So one of the only things that they say here that, you know, isn't as positive, it says, meanwhile, Cohen estimates it will take almost 6 years for blockchain to gain widespread adoption. So pretty much he says, hey, you know, not a lot of companies are using blockchain right now. We're still really early in the development stages, so it's going to take some time. But even with that, Amazon wants to propel that and kind of, you know, excel that adoption. So hopefully it takes a shorter amount of time. So, you know, it's great to see that Amazon, again, is implementing these, you know, resources into their blockchain technology. And hopefully this will incentivize other companies to do so, so that mainstream adoption can happen that much faster. So just some more positive news I want to bring out today, you know, with all this bearish market that's been going on. But again, you know, we've had some bullish action in the past couple of days. Hopefully it continues. Hopefully we maintain these support levels. So we'll just have to see what happens. But if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, leave a comment if you can, and please subscribe if you haven't. It really helps out the channel. So until next time, thanks for watching.